Vibe is underwritten by Kopicki Photography, 300 Cherry Street, Reading, PA, 19602.
Hi, good evening. I'm Marcia.
And I'm Jack.
And welcome to Berks Vibe. We have an exciting show tonight.
We always have an exciting show.
Well, this is true. Ice cream and fashion.
Yeah, we were at the Oley Valley Dairy restaurant and petting zoo.
Yes.
It was fun.
It was great.
Marcia, I think we started out thinking, okay, let's do this segment and move on, but we stayed a lot longer than we thought we would.
And I think our viewers will see how much fun it is. So, and we're going to be seeing that real shortly. And then after that, we're going to have the Goodwill Runway show, and it is secondhand chic, and it is very cool, very amazing. We're actually going to have a model, and we're going to hear all about Goodwill and the cool fundraiser that's going on. But first,
we're going to meet with Darlene Moser from Oley Valley Dairy. I think she was initially a little shy and didn't want to be on camera, but we had a really nice time. Great ice cream.
The ice cream is really good.
We actually love the petting zoo, a free petting zoo.
It was clean. It was fun, and
I think we're fussy about things like that.
I think so. Yeah, I'm a real animal person. These animals were happy campers.
Well cared for.
Yes. So, without further ado,
let's see it.
Let's see it.
Hi, I'm Jack.
And I'm Marcia.
And we're at the Oley Turnpike Diner with owner Darlene Moser. Thanks for having us, Darlene.
Thanks for coming.
It's a great
place. Diner or dairy?
Dairy diner.
Dairy diner. Dairy diner. So it's dairy diner. Diner, dairy, diner, dairy.
Marcia, seems like they have a lot of everything.
It is a diner and a dairy. Well, it's not an official dairy, really. But you do have a lot of ice cream.
Right.
Tell us about, I think when people think of the Oley Turnpike Dairy Diner, they immediately think of ice cream because it's summer, it's hot. So tell us a little about the selection of ice creams that you have that people can expect when they come down here. What are some of the great flavors and the sundaes and all that kind of stuff that you offer?
Well, I personally like the moose tracks, the chocolate moose tracks. We have all kinds of sundaes. We have milkshakes in any flavor. Mint chocolate chip, butter pecan, anything you like.
You're telling me that your milkshakes are pretty hot right now.
Mm-hmm.
They're going like
they're very nice and thick, and everybody seems to like them.
I saw that you have apple dumplings on the apple dumplings.
We have delicious apple dumplings. They're made by an Amish lady, and they're very, very good. The best.
Very good. Well, actually, you have, that's the dairy part of it, but when you go over there, you've got a lot of produce and cantaloupes and corn and animal crackers, which we'll get to later.
They have antiques over there as well.
I mean, it's just like a really eclectic, great little place. Mm-hmm. But we're actually sitting in the diner here, and tell us a little bit about the kind of food that you have here, because it's all made from scratch, right?
Right. My husband and I are Dutchmen, and of course we like that Pennsylvania Dutch food, the roast beefs, the
Pot pie.
Oh yeah, the sausage, anything Pennsylvania Dutch we make here.
And you're open in the morning as well for breakfast.
6 a.m. for breakfast, right.
Wow. Mm-hmm. And what's your specialty?
Breakfast, anything.
Oh, very good. Now, are you open year-round, or are you really just open in the summer, darling?
No, we're open year-round. Shorter hours, but we're open.
Your petting zoo is open also same time?
It'll be open all year.
All year.
Mm-hmm. The baked goods that you have, all of that comes from the Amish lady, or, you know?
Yes. Yes, it does. The apple dumplings, the shoe fly pies, whoopie pies, and chocolate chip whoopies. All good.
A little whoopie pie. Mm-hmm. Do you also get breads from the same person?
No, the breads actually come from the Oley baker, and they're very good, too.
No preservatives or anything.
Right,
those
right.
Now, you're not a working dairy anymore. I know Jack was asking you if you made your own ice cream, but you don't do that anymore. What kind of ice cream do you have?
Oh, we have Nelson's, and it's very good ice cream. It's excellent quality. when we took over the dairy again, we looked for the best, and I think we found it. So come and try it.
You took over the dairy again. You've owned this business for how long?
The store was built in 1970, and we've always owned the store, but we've had different people lease it over the years. And
so you're back
we
in business.
Seem to get it back each time, but we're back again.
Well, we're glad to have you. I'm
There's
sure
no
the neighborhood is.
You weren't digging retirement anyway.
No, not really. I'm not the retiring type.
But you like to go to flea markets. Tell us about your antique shop.
Well, we have a few little antiques in here, and I've been dabbling in antiques for years and selling some of the things that I have and
some pretty
buying
plates
some.
Some nice mm-hmm. plates in back there as well.
Yeah, a few things. They can stop and look at antiques or
all kinds of stuff. What are your hours? You open it obviously at 6 a.m. for breakfast, and then how late do you stay open?
Right now, we're open 6 a.m. to 8:30 p.m. in the restaurant and 9:30 p.m. in ice cream. That will change after it gets colder.
Mm-hmm. We're going to be heading out to the petting zoo shortly, but you actually have an event here. You have a fall festival, do you call it?
Yes.
Why don't you tell us about that, darling?
Well, we celebrate the fall season with corn and mazes and hay rides and
good old fashioned hay
play
rides.
Area.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Pumpkins, do you sell pumpkins?
Yeah, we sell pumpkins. Anything full.
Sounds like mm-hmm. fun. When does that start?
That starts the last week of September, mm-hmm. on through all of October. And hay rides and mazes every Saturday and Sunday that the public can just come in to see to take the hay rides.
Sounds like fun.
I think it is.
It's fun for us.
And you know what? That's what matters, because it keeps you going. It keeps you wanting.
It's good
to.
For groups, because we're pretty reasonable here. It'll be $5 a person for the groups, which is very reasonable for what we do. A nice hay ride, the play area.
Does that include the petting zoo, or you were saying the petting zoo is actually free?
The petting zoo is free. We hope for a donation. We don't get too many of them, but we have a box out there, and people can come just to see the petting zoo if they wish.
It's nice to purchase the cracker. They can purchase cracker, the animal crackers, and get those.
Right. That's the only thing they can feed, because USDA, which we are under, mm-hmm. wants to keep control of what the animals are fed. In other words, people can't come in and bring us 15 apples and feed it to one little goat.
Mm-hmm. Right.
That would make the animals sick. So we have to take care of our animals.
What kind of animals? Name a couple.
Not your customers.
We have wallabies. We have a lot of monkeys. We have capuchins. We have...
Wait, what
capuchin?
Was that?
Capuchin.
A what? Oh, a monkey.
Monkey.
Yeah,
monkey.
We have 5 capuchins. We have a snow monkey. We have wallabies. We have zebu, miniature zebu.
Wow.
What's a zebu?
It's the little cow with the hump.
I never heard of half these animals. Have I lived under
city
a rock?
People.
Like what? I know. I'm not that much of a city person. I've been to a zoo.
Well, this one has quite a few animals.
Exotic animals. This isn't exotic.
Yeah, I thought it was. I thought we were gonna have cows and pigs and goats.
You don't pet pigs, Jack.
Well, you can look.
It's a petting zoo.
Oh, petting zoo.
You don't pet a pig.
Well, I better not. Thank you.
God. Well, we're already having a lot of fun in the Oley Turnpike Dairy Petting Zoo.
Yeah.
And this is a great petting zoo. I have to tell you, these animals are absolutely precious.
Yeah.
They're totally digging on the crackers. Jack right now is feeding the spitting llama. No, I'm kidding. She doesn't spit. Do they have names, darling?
These don't, unfortunately.
Well, you need to name them.
That's
Jack. Jackie, give them a name.
Jack and Marcia.
How about that?
I want to be the pretty white one.
What are they? Are they boys or girls?
In the spring.
Okay, are they boys or girls?
We have one boy in there and one girl.
There you go.
Jack and Marcia.
And Jill.
Jack and Jill. Jack and Marcia.
Oh, okay. Oh. But anyway, this is absolutely adorable. It's wide open. It's fun to feed the animals. Tell us again the different animals. I know we saw goats and we saw those cool like little miniature cows and we have the alpaca and we have a cool mule. But kind of tell us some other things that people can see when they come here.
Well, we have 3 fallow deer. We have a lot of wallabies. We have monkeys. We have zebu. We have... ring-tailed lemurs. We have a lot of animals.
Well, and I think
yeah,
well, I think what's neat too is like these are animals that you like. A lot of us have seen a goat, but a lot of the things that you've mentioned you don't normally see, and I've never quite frankly heard of, and it's great fun to feed them. But I think too, this is free, so you're always looking for donations.
Absolutely. There's a box where they come in. We hope people give donations when they arrive or when they leave. Mm-hmm. A lot of people don't, but it's an expensive venture to run.
And it looks like they're well fed, I'll tell you.
Oh, they're well fed. Definitely well fed.
Some chunky
you won't
animals.
Find a thin one amongst them.
No, no, they're definitely happy and just some really cool. And they're so sweet. They're so friendly. The baby, the fainting goats, I loved them. They don't faint anymore.
They do very little fainting anymore. When we first got them, they were frightened. But the more people they see, the less they faint.
Very nice.
Well, that's good. What are your favorites?
The wallabies.
Did we see a wallaby?
Oh, okay. We're getting to them. We have albino wallabies and brown wallabies.
They eat the same crackers?
Mm-hmm. Everybody eats the same crackers.
These are crackers
that you can eat them, too.
You're just wrong sometimes, Jack.
A little bland.
You're just wrong. They need a little jam.
They do need a little jam.
I didn't even think of that. It's only you would eat the petting zoo crackers.
Not bad. Ursula would, too.
Them too.
Well, that's good to know that if your child does eat them, it's okay.
Right.
All right. And this is because you are USDA.
Right. They would like you to keep control of the food so that people don't come in and bring apples and grass. Grass shouldn't be fed to them. So we charge them for the crackers inside, and it helps with the cost of the petting zoo. Mm-hmm.
All right. Very good. Well, I think I want to check out the wallabies and the monkeys and the lemurs and what else is in there?
Well, a lot of
the donkeys there.
Parrots of all kinds.
What are the girls down there? Aren't there five more donkeys?
Miniature donkeys.
Miniature
donkeys. These are old girls down here. Here's a little boy that's going to call you to feed him.
Mm-hmm. Oh, he was calling me earlier.
Yeah, he was calling you.
Screaming to be fed.
Oh, absolutely. That's just the thought of a cracker will send them wild.
And it's true. We walked in, they heard the crinkle, and they went like crazy.
Yeah,
so.
If you don't have any crackers, you're not going to get their attention.
Well, they're so cute, being in the miniatures are so cute, and you said that... People like miniatures.
People like babies, and when you have miniature zebu, they look like babies, even though they're not going to grow, and it's good for the zoo to have unusual things.
inside. This is literally a zoo. This is not
it's
a,
like a little mini zoo.
It's
like,
incredible.
This is beyond a petting zoo, darling.
This is beautiful.
I know.
You need to remarry it away. But this is great. Tell us what we're seeing here. I mean,
poaching monkeys.
They are going crazy.
Oh, yeah. Gosh. What's that, Jack, near you?
What's that near
this
you?
This gray guy. Yeah. How do you feed him?
Ring-tailed boomer.
Oh, he's beautiful.
Don't.
Oh, no, I don't want to do that. Please.
Look at him.
They want...
I have never seen that.
I think they
gouged
my
beautiful.
Eyes out. They are beautiful. Hello.
Now, this is open on a Sunday night between 4 and 5. They can come in here and see the animals up close.
Wow. That is really up close.
So you. Just Sundays from 4 to 5.
Behind plexiglass so nobody can get hurt. And she's making a scene, let's put it.
Yes, but she's on camera. How cute.
Look at
her. She's jumping. Oh, my God, Jackie, look at her.
That is incredible.
Usually when somebody's in, we open the door and throw stuff in, so they're just excited because they think they're
they
going to get a treat.
Well, yeah. They know they are.
Mm-hmm. Well, this is great.
Can't feed these.
No.
Well, that's probably safer. They look delicate.
Yeah.
Right. So, and in the other room, we've got the parrots. Right. Beautiful birds.
Macaws, and you can talk to them through the fence.
I
they say a lot of words.
I thought somebody was saying something. It was one of the parrots.
Oh, they say hello and cracker and all kinds of fruits.
Cracker.
And goodbye.
Oh,
they say all kinds
beautiful.
Of words.
This is truly a treat out here. I mean, don't get me wrong. I look at her, Sean. But I mean, I was going to say, I mean, I like love ice cream, but this is really a highlight of
absolutely.
The Oley Turnpike Dairy. This has been great fun, really. They have such personalities. Oh my God, Sean, turn your camera and look at him. Oh my God.
Little snack.
Oh my God. Well, Darlene, thank you so much. This has been an absolute treat. This has just been great fun. So thank you for having us here.
Thank you for coming.
Okay.
And remember, if you come out, it's out Oley Turnpike Road. And if you come visit the petting zoo, and even if you don't, consider giving a donation because
what's the phone number?
610-689-9366.
All right. Thank you.
Here we go. Who's a Piggly Wiggly, huh?
I had fun all over again.
Thanks, Sean, for getting me doing the Piggly Wiggly. Very nice.
But seriously, that is, I mean, we kind of lost sight of the dairy part of it, but the ice cream's great, the petting zoo is great, and it was just
well, at the
a
end, we washed our hands and had some ice
cream. We did.
You had a little bit of
we
ice
cream. We did. Darlene was a wonderful hostess, and she did a great job.
Yeah,
so.
Very much fun.
But anyway.
Go down.
Check it out.
It's really neat.
It's very cool. So, but anyway, I think we're ready for our top five. And I know they're going to be kind of the graphics. Yes, we're having a slight graphic glitch here at BCTV.
Low tech tonight.
So bear with us. But my first one is the 44th annual Durier Day in Boyertown. It's September 5th, 9 to 4. It's at the Boyertown Community Park, South Madison Street. You can actually register your car to show it there, or just go check out all the antique and classic cars and the truck show and the flea market, and there's food and all that other good stuff. The number to check that out is 610-367-2090. Second one is the good old annual Chili Pepper Festival.
You go to that, don't you?
I've never been to it.
Oh, somebody else, Sherry.
Yeah, I've always wanted to go to it. They've been on the show to promote it, but apparently it's just like a really big deal. It's a Friday and a Saturday, the 11th and 12th. 9 to 6 both days. It's in Bowers, but they've got the foods and the crafts and the plants and the field excursions, contest music, the whole 9 yards. So it's held rain or shine, and they do have a site. I think if you just type in annual Chili Pepper Food Festival, Berks County, you'll find it, or you can call 610-944-6568. The next one is the Mounds Jones Annual Country Fair and Harvest Festival, and that's Saturday the 26th from 10 to 4 at Old Morlanton Village. Near Old Douglas Philadelphia Pike in Douglasville. If you've never heard of the Historical Preservation Trust of Berks County, they do amazing things. They renovate pieces of history here in Berks County. And they're actually working on a current house called the Deturk House. But this is one of their fundraisers, and you can check out that, and then the Old White Horse Tavern is also open. But they're going to have crafts and antiques and a bake sale. And yeah, it is. So,
and the Mounds Joneses.
Well, actually, I asked them that. Mounds Jones is two last names, but it's the oldest house here in Berks County in, you know, Swedish Sweden. The first settlers were from Sweden.
Wow.
I know, not German like you'd think. So Mounds Jones is actually two different names. Then the next one is Love the IMAX, and they have partnered with the Greater Reading Film Festival, and they do a night of independent films. I think it's the fourth Sunday of each month, and then it follows with kind of a panel discussion. But if you're into independent film, you can check it out at the IMAX. And that is, the next one is coming up Sunday, September 27th from at 7 p.m. and at 9 p.m. So readingfilmfestival.com for more information there. And then lastly, Antietam Lake is a great area. And if you like to hike, Sunday, September 13th at 10 a.m., starting in the parking lot right there at 230 Angora Road, you can enjoy a full morning hike and learn about the history and trails of Antietam Lake.
That sounds like fun.
Yeah, you can just go to countyofberks.com/parks, but that's Sunday, September 13th at 10 a.m. if you're
very
interested
nice.
In that.
Sounds
yeah.
like fun.
Yeah.
So. Yeah, there they are.
There they are.
Oh, I think mine are smaller, but I have a list too.
Yes.
Saturday, September 5th. It's my mom's birthday, by the way. Happy birthday, Mom. I love you. September 5th. Saturday, September 5th from 10 to 5, 6th annual Downtown Hamburg Taste of Hamburger Festival. It's free with entertainers, crafts, food, and foods available. They also have a chili cook-off and best burger contest. Go to www.hamburgpa.org or call 610-562-3106. Saturday, September 12th, the Hendel House Mansion Picnic. It's in the Center Park area at 746 Center Avenue in Reading from 11 a.m. to 4 p.m. Visit the beautifully restored Victorian home in the Center Park District while enjoying chicken or pork sandwich dinner, listening to ragtime music. Tickets are $10. Make reservations by calling 610-375-4375. Saturday, September 19th, the Butch Sullivan Memorial Golf Tournament at Chapel Hill Golf Course. The cost is $70 per person. That includes 18 holes, skill prizes, dinner, refreshments, and more. For more information, call Rosemary Sullivan at 610-775-9229. Thursday, September 19th through Saturday, September 17th through Saturday, September 19th, the Oley Valley Fair. Always a good
French
time
fries.
At the Oley Fire. Yeah. The lines
fries.
Are so long
they
sometimes.
Are.
Friday
I
nights.
They have good French
really.
Fries.
Great food.
Yep.
Oley Valley Fair, the Oley Valley Fire Company Fairgrounds, Route 73 and 662. From 9 a.m. I didn't realize it started that early. 9
well,
a.m.
They have animals that they show, and don't they have agricultural things?
I guess.
Yeah.
You take your winning peppers.
You could.
Yeah.
No, my peppers didn't do too well this year.
Too much rain. 9 a.m. to 11 p.m. For more information, go to www.oleyfair.org or call 610-987-3423. And Wednesday, September 23rd through Saturday, September 26th, Carsonia Park Carnival at Carsonia Park in Pennside.
Where is that?
In Carsonia.
Where in Carsonia?
I don't know.
Okay, I mean, I know that area.
It's near I guess it's right at Antietam.
Do you know
pool.
Where it is, Susan? Carsonia Park?
I think it's near the pool.
Yeah.
Oh,
I think
okay.
It's right
it's near the
next
pool.
To the pool.
Mm-hmm.
I believe so.
Okay.
Because I think that's where the original, does anybody know the original carnival was?
See, I didn't know, so I just was curious.
I believe so.
Anyway, sorry.
Sorry, Marcia. I'll have to research.
Exactly. You should. I mean, yeah.
But
that makes
you
sense
know
that
down
it's by
there.
The pool. Yeah.
Right. Rides, games, food, live music. Wednesday and Thursday ride night a special. Arts and crafts show, barbecue chicken. For more information, email vanessa1shop@yahoo.com or phone 610-370-3385.
You know, there's so many great things to do here in Berks County. It's always hard for us just to pick top five in the month. But we're going to talk to about the Goodwill Runway Show now, and that is Thursday, September 10th.
Correct.
And that is a very cool thing, and it is a fundraiser, but I'll tell you what, you're going to have a lot of fun at this thing. There's food and hors d'oeuvres and some great fashions. So without further ado, I'd like to introduce our guests. We have Jennifer Ross, and you are the Senior Director of Marketing and PR for Goodwill.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have Susan Golembisky.
Correct.
And you're the owner of Frock. Correct. And you also are adjunct at Albright. So
Correct.
Welcome both of you very much.
Thank you for having us.
Oh,
really
this is a very cool idea.
Yeah, we're very excited about it.
Yeah. Well, we'll get into the event, but I think Goodwill, when somebody says Goodwill, immediately you think, oh, I've donated to that.
Yeah. I go there,
I donate, whatever. And you think, I'm doing my part, I've given my clothes or I've given this, and certainly that's the case, but...
Where does the money go?
Right, you made a really good point, like, where is that going? So,
right.
Tell us a little bit about Goodwill and what you're about, and you're kind of going through a rebranding, so bring us up to speed
on Goodwill.
And then we'll get to your fundraiser. Yeah.
And you know what, I'm so glad that you brought that up, because we are so much more than just a store or the store down the corner, and a lot of our shoppers and donors know that they're doing something good when they come to us, and they know we're doing something good, but they're not sure what it's all about. Mm-hmm. And what we do is our stores actually fund job training, job programs, and services for people with disabilities. Okay. And if I take a step back and talk about our philosophy of work, as we know, work is really important because it provides a paycheck, yeah. And there's no doubt about that. But it really provides just so much more. It provides connections. It helps us grow and it gives us self-confidence.
Absolutely.
And self-esteem and structure. And those things are really important. And actually, in these times, people are really wanting those connections. It's very difficult. Actually, there's been studies done by people who've won the lottery, and they've gone on to stop working, and they've actually experienced depression because they didn't work. Work is really important.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And everybody should have the ability and right to work. And for many years, people with disabilities have been defined by what they can't do. And at Goodwill, we define people by what they can do.
Oh, that's great.
And we also believe in giving, rather than a handout, a hand up. So we help people with disabilities find what are they good at, what do they want to do, and really find the right training and job opportunities for each person. And actually, our stores serve as training grounds. Our stores, our donation centers, our sorting centers, they can either be training grounds or jobs full-time for people. Giving people a chance. It's just so important. And we're actually like the community's HR partner. We work with different businesses in Berks County. Giant food stores would be one for someone who's ready for competitive employment.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll place them in a position. And if there's any trouble, maybe they're having a hard time adjusting to change or maybe a project, we have Goodwill job coaches, and they go out and they work with that individual. So we help people in a lot of different ways. So as you can see, we're really more than just a store.
Oh, absolutely. Now, if you have somebody or know somebody who would fall into that category, can they just call up? Who do they call? Because, I mean, I think Goodwill... The face of Goodwill really is the stores.
It's the store.
So who, or if you're an employer and you would say, you know, I'm willing to give somebody a chance or whatever, who would they contact? Like, where do you start?
Actually, we have 34 counties that we serve. We have offices in Harrisburg, right here in Shillington, and Fort Washington, Pottsville, Lancaster. So we're all over. We have employment specialists really helping people with disabilities either get the job training they need or placing them in different positions throughout the community. And we help young people, we help seniors, so there's a really wide variety of services. And they can call any of our locations, and they could find those locations on our website, and that's yourgoodwill.org.
Okay, great. Mm-hmm. Very good.
I know probably every one of us have gone into a Goodwill store, purchase a maybe clothes for a costume party or
yeah.
And I think some of those fashions you might have tonight on are at least at the show. So we've all stepped our foot
right.
feet inside Goodwill.
Right, and it's all, you know, when you go shopping, the great thing is it's kind of guilt-free shopping because mm-hmm. you're finding great
reasonable.
Things, very mm-hmm. reasonable. We have brand names. A lot of clothes with the tags still on, and it's going to a great cause. It's going to change people's lives, and that's what's really important. We don't give up on anyone. We keep working with them. And sometimes we might not find the right position for them, but we keep trying. And actually, here in Berks County, I just met a young man who was really struggling on the academic side. However, he really loved to be outside, and we found a farm, and he's working with horses, grooming them, you know, doing maintenance on the farm. He absolutely loves it. He's actually been there for 4 years, and it's my understanding he hasn't missed a day of work.
Isn't that wonderful? Incredible.
Yeah, these are people are very loyal. They want to work. Mm-hmm. They love it.
Find your niche. Find what you like to
and
do.
And we should all do that.
Mm-hmm.
So, yes, absolutely.
Yeah, so
absolutely.
It's a great cause. We're very, very proud of our mission, and we just really want to spread the word about what we do.
Absolutely. So, which leads us to your fundraiser, which I think also proves the point where, yes, you might go to Goodwill to get a costume, but you also can find some really great finds there. And
yeah.
as we're going to see through Susan's work, we'll have a model, but you can alter it or bring it up to date or whatever, perfectly good clothes that are in good shape if you know somebody or if you yourself are handy like that.
Susan, so. You're pretty talented.
Thank you.
Very nice.
Very talented.
It's been a lot of fun. We're having a lot of fun with this. My business is in my home, so it's like this big girl party. Mm-hmm. Once or twice a week, we get together and just tie on clothes and have a good time.
That's awesome. Yeah. But you have the eye. You can see it.
Yeah, most people have an eye. They just have to be shown.
Be shown how to do it. So.
Okay, sell yourself. Sure.
I know. That's what I was thinking. She's designed or redesigned 80 outfits for this runway show.
Oh.
You know?
Let's back up a little bit.
Okay.
And
when's the show?
Thursday, September 10th.
What
and
time?
4:29.
4:29.
It's going to start at 4:29. I remember that. We're like, wait, it's like a good.
Can't forget that.
No, that's why we decided it would stick in people's minds.
Yep.
And you know, why wait till 4:30?
Mm-hmm.
You know, we're going to start happy hour. So what we have at 4:29 to about 6:00, people can start off by having drinks, hors d'oeuvres. And all that's donated. That's the really great thing. Like Isaac's will be there, Why a Missing Family Restaurant. Giant is donating different platters so people can network, just relax after work. And then we are going to move everyone into the runway show.
Where is it going to take
place? It's actually at the VF Outlet. So on the third level, Designer's Place. Mm-hmm. So really excited
pretty
about
large,
that.
Pretty large
Very
area.
Large venue. Mm-hmm. It's going to be very industrial chic. So we're very excited. We have lights, music, we have a DJ, and the models. We have about 30 models. We'll be strutting their stuff, and Susan's done an absolute fantastic job with these outfits.
Susan, ages of the models?
18 to, she's going to kill me, 41.
Then we have a back seat.
You can't tell. She's a knockout.
So it's basically, you've taken things that you found in the stores
right.
and you've reworked them
right.
for the fashion show. And that's just kind of the fun part of it. That's kind of just to come and have some fun. But if you see something you like, you were saying that you can actually buy it after the show.
For Goodwill prices.
That
is
and then
right.
you've got some other little gift baskets. So tell us a little more about the boutique afterwards.
That's right. Actually, before the runway show starts, we're going to have a silent auction and a raffle so people can bid and get a whole bunch of great things. Then there's the runway show. After that, we're going to have a ready-to-go boutique so people can turn around, shop. We're going to have clothes, shoes, bags, accessories. Some of the clothes that will be featured in the runway show we are going to sell after the show.
Cool.
And like you said, it's going to be at Goodwill prices, so it's just a nice touch. And again, all of these proceeds benefit Goodwill's mission and help people with disabilities.
Now, it'll benefit the ones here in Pennsylvania. Is this one just going to benefit Berks County, or is it really for the whole unit in Pennsylvania?
It benefits people in Berks County. And actually, one of our largest programs that we have for youth is right here in Berks County. It's a summer youth employment program. And many of the youth it's the first time they're getting a paycheck. And that's a great feeling, a great memory to earn that first paycheck.
Yep.
So not only are they training, but they're getting paid for what they're doing. So it's the summer youth program here in Berks County. We recently just wrapped it up, and we helped almost 90 young adults.
Wow. That's great.
That's great. So that will go to you, Susan. And how did you get involved in such a very cool project?
I had a storefront on Penn Avenue that had retail. I've since closed that and moved the alterations and design studio back home. Mm-hmm. But Miss Jennifer Sly came in because she was sent there by some people that knew me. You know, Berks County is very small. And the arts community is kind of small.
Yes.
Connections.
And I'm known for my redoing of clothing and remaking and repurposing and alter couture. And that's what the way she wanted to go for the show.
Okay.
She didn't just want to put the ready-to-wear out.
Mm-hmm.
So we got together. She provided the models, like 20 to 30 most of the most like dynamic young women in Berks County. It was a lot of fun.
Cool.
And we just, I have a couple of assistants, and we just started loading up the car. We go to the Goodwill and pick and take like carloads into my house and sort through and redo. It was a little hectic at first because we were trying to match the sizes and the outfits and the models, but it became more streamlined. The process became easier as time went on.
Mm-hmm.
And some items are right off the rack. They were not touched at all.
They
just did the styling and the accessories.
Okay.
Some items you wouldn't recognize, and some are just brought up to date. We have a lot of 80s items. Mm-hmm. Volume is back in fashion now, so it was easy to pull some of the more the high-waisted pants, the things with more volume in them, just tweak down the shoulder pads, and you've got something that looks right out of vogue.
Shoulder pads will ever come back?
Hopefully not the way they were. I don't know what we were thinking.
Scary.
I was there. I did it.
Maybe you'll bring it back with your fashions.
I'll put them somewhere else. But no, that was not a good look for most women. It made your hips look smaller. That's one thing. But
Go ahead.
You have men's fashions as well,
and
you tweak some men's fashions.
I had to alter some things. It's hard to find something off a rack that fits. You know, 98% of women can't buy something and walk out in it. And then we have some young men that are having some fun with this.
All sizes?
Yes.
So you'll have all sizes for sale at the show.
That was very important to us.
How many garments, and I don't know if that's the word you want to use, are you going to have available at the show?
It's called Looks, and probably between 80 and 100.
Looks.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they call it Looks.
So how long will the show be? Like, it's going to be at least
20 to 30 minutes will be the
actual
show.
Wow, that's all it'll take to show all those.
Mm-hmm.
Holy moly.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Wow.
So there's going to be a lot of energy. I mean, we've really worked on making it perfect with the music, matching the lights, matching the looks.
That's cool. And how are you doing, like you were saying, industrial chic? Like, what is that? Is that just sort of warehouse, warehouse coolness or with lights?
Raw metal.
Okay.
Yeah, pretty much. And we're really bringing a recycle theme, the green theme. It ties in very well with this. For example, we're bringing some things in, like some vases, some housewares that you can find at our stores, and we're putting it into the show or into the beginning of the event when people are networking, so they can really check out some other things that they can buy at Goodwill and maybe redesign their own house, too.
Are there Goodwill stickers on them for them to buy?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Payment, can they pay?
You know, a couple different ways. Right now it's $40 for a ticket. The day of the event, September 10th, they can buy a ticket. It's $45 at the show. And there's a couple ways people can buy tickets. One is just going to our website, and that's yourgoodwill.org. They also can go to the store at Bell Tower or Spring Valley Athletic Club, and they're selling tickets as well.
Great.
Plus, purchasing items there, how can they purchase items? Only cash? Or?
No, cash, check, credit cards.
Great.
We will take them.
Easy.
That's we're making it as easy as possible so people can get what they want and walk right out with fall trends and some new outfits and some new looks.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, let's bring Monica out, and you can...
Monica Toulé?
Yes, this
is Monica.
Hi, Monica.
And she's just looking so New York. Mm-hmm. What's that new show, New York Prep? Or?
Yeah, the prep school.
Oh,
yes.
My God, how cute. So
Monica is a student of mine from Albright.
Very good.
Monica's wearing, it's a vintage 1970s blazer. It's dead stock. It still had the tags on it.
Okay.
So it's considered
great
new,
condition.
Even though it's old. Yes, it's perfect. We paired this with a 1980s rayon paisley. It's their split. It was, what are they called? Gauchos from
I
the
couch.
Is paisley coming back then?
Paisley's always there.
Oh, always
yeah.
there.
That's always there.
Okay.
This has an elastic high waist, which is coming back. The fashion is redefining the waist a little bit more.
Okay.
And the vintage blouse is from the 30s and a sweater probably from the 90s underneath. And pretty. The whole look, I'm a fan of the bins at Goodwill. I don't, the racks are too easy for me.
Uh-huh.
So the whole look was probably $3.
So you get no excited way. When you're digging
wow.
the bins.
Oh yeah, it's like
but
something.
Like, but
yeah.
my uh-huh. point is, like, you could look at that, and you know, I think, I hear what you're saying, but you know uh-huh. how to sew. You know how to alter.
All I had to do was hem. All this had to be done was hem. Hemming's not hard. There's glue. You can do it.
That's glue.
Yeah. Take a class. I teach.
I
hey, if you need something
sell.
Done, uh-huh. you can take it to see.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
All you need is a good tailor and a little imagination.
Mm-hmm. That's yeah. exactly it.
Yeah, but this is our career casual look. There's mm-hmm. 8 categories in the show.
Oh, what are the 8 categories?
Eclectic, like the young kids that roll out of bed and go to class.
Yeah, that look like they're together.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, and only they can pull it off.
Yes.
Then we have resort, career casual, career chic, vintage, club wear, little black dress, and bridal formula.
How great.
Great.
Mm-hmm.
You're telling us you have some exciting little tales.
For the show, you mean?
Yeah.
We've got some interesting things. We've got some really great girls with fabulous personalities, and we tried to use the personalities with the clothing. Yeah, we think is really going to shine.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Fun.
Mm-hmm.
That is so cool.
Mm-hmm. Did you want to go with the other
Good.
One?
Good. Okay. All right, well, Monica, we'll see our next. Mm-hmm. It's like a really cool dress, and that used to
yes.
be just sort of
right off the rack. I didn't do a thing to it.
Mm-hmm.
The show is 30 minutes. How long is the entire event?
It starts at 4:29, like we were talking about, uh-huh. and it ends about 7:30.
And so is it finished after 7:30 or anything else
going
on?
People can shop around 7 to 7:30. So, you know, if we have a lot of anxious and excited shoppers and they want to stick around, well, mm-hmm. we'll keep the doors open a little bit longer.
But there's something after this. There's
the exclusive after party.
I knew there was something else after.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And anyone.
First on Berks Vibe,
yes.
Right?
And yes. anyone is.
Can we tell them where? Can we tell them
Viva.
Where? Viva. The
Viva.
New and improved Viva.
New and improved Viva, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so, and anyone can attend. You don't need a ticket. You don't need to pay anything extra.
Mm-hmm.
Just head on over, and they're actually going to have, is that Runway Teenies?
I don't know about that, but they're going to have tableside modeling.
Oh, yes.
Runway Teenies?
Yes, we're going to have Runway Teenies there.
Oh, cool.
And we're going to have some of our models and other people from this year are going to come on over, and they are going to model some different outfits as well.
Nice.
That
yeah.
you made, or
that
you
I put together. We went,
for
yeah.
Sure.
I had to alter a few things, but I was just there to coach the putting together of the outfit.
See, that's yeah. so very.
But these
cool.
girls have great style. They define.
They just know. They just.
Yeah.
Know.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that's
there's a lot there. Mm-hmm.
Well, and I think that's the important thing too to remember is like when you go in a Goodwill store, you're not quite sure, you know, like oh, it's all going to be old and out
mm-hmm.
of date and all of that, but. What is your process? I've always wondered that. Because, you know, you always stuff a whole lot of stuff in a bag or you bring a whole lot of stuff in
What's
a box.
What's the process?
What's the process? Like, does everybody, do you take everything that everybody gives you or do you kind of really go through everything?
We do. We really make sure that we value every donation.
Right.
You can find a really good home. As far as clothes and housewares, with the clothes, we take a look to make sure that there's not any stains, that they're not wet or anything like that,
mm-hmm.
that they're not torn. And those items would go out. We want to make sure we have high quality items in
right.
our stores.
Mm-hmm.
If there happens to be maybe a small tear in a sweater or some jeans, then that would go into our bin stores.
Okay.
And those items you can get for 75 cents a piece.
Mm-hmm.
Things that are really torn or there's stains, what happens is that they actually go onto, there's a market for those type of clothes. And what we always want to make sure people understand is, yes, these clothes could go to third world countries, but what's really important is that that money from that market funds the local program.
Exactly.
So we really try to find a home for every donation and really make use of it.
We donate to Goodwill several bags a year. My wife will tell me, do not put that in. Nobody will want that because it has a stain
oh, no.
or a little hole. So
no, we will find a home for it.
It.
Yeah, absolutely. We try to make sure that we can find
just we really value the donation. It really helps our programs and our services. And as funding is shrinking out there, because we do depend on, you know, the general public to support our programs, we also support, we also depend on government for support. And as those dollars are shrinking, you know, the shirts with a little tear in them, that's okay, because that really helps continue the funding. We can sell it in the stores, or we can sell it on the salvage market, but regardless, it stays here, and the money stays here in central Pennsylvania.
You have an online store too, don't you?
Yes, we do. And
is that where you pick the good stuff?
Yeah, well, something like that. We were talking about that earlier. It's Shop Goodwill. And it's really unique in that so many items come through, and some of the really interesting items, and that might be a little bit more worth more than $1.97 or $4.97. We put on, it's kind of almost
it's
like eBay.
It is, yeah.
But again, the money comes back to Central Pennsylvania and helps support people with disabilities. Yeah. So we really try to find a home and use every dollar wisely for our programs and services.
Local people decide, hey, we should put this on Shop Goodwill.
It's We've got some fantastic sorters, and they really have an eye, whether things should go in the store or they should go on shopgoodwill.com.
Right, I think you learn sometimes you have an item, you think, oh, that's pretty nice, let's put it on for a small amount, but then you see it explode to this large amount, and then you get that eye for the next time something like that comes in.
So we tell people, if they can't make it to our stores, go to shopgoodwill.com, and they'll find some really great, maybe some antique and collectible items there as well.
That's very cool. Now this started, I know, Susan, you were saying you heard about it on NPR, as in the Goodwill Runway Show, and that started in D.C., so this is
kind
of modeled after that.
That's right. We went down to Washington, D.C. to check it out, and it just is, it makes a lot of sense. And this is the first time we have ever done it, Goodwill Keystone area.
Okay.
We wanted to do it in Berks County. It's just such a fantastic community, a giving community, a very supportive community, and we have just found so much success, and the community has really embraced this fundraiser. We've got a lot of support from people like Susan, very generous with their time, Bell Tower. So we've been very fortunate. And the reason why it's going to be successful is because of the people in Berks County. Yeah, exactly.
Did you want to mention to Highmark Blue Shield and some of your committee members?
Oh, we have a wonderful committee. Like you said, Highmark has been a long time sponsor and supporter of Goodwill, and you know, I can go on and on about our committee members.
Right.
Susan is one, and they're very supportive.
Frock, do you want to tell us phone number, website, or anything that you have?
I have
for
a website, www, which is stupid to say, I know. frockonpen.com.
Okay.
And there's a calendar there where you can find, I hold classes in my house.
Oh, cool.
And
you can learn to sew. I have always wanted to do that.
Well, it's a lot of fun. Anybody can do it. It's
now,
like driving a car.
I guess when I ask this, you're going to just look at me. Do you have to have a sewing machine, or can you
I have some portables you may borrow.
Okay. I'm so excited.
It's a lot of fun. It's a lot of fun.
I've always wanted to do it. And then I thought, oh, why start now? Because to really become a really good seamstress, you probably just need years and years of practice.
It's like driving a car. It's a skill. Anybody can learn it.
When someone teaches you. Monica's ready. She
looks great. I'm going to learn how to sew. My husband's rolling his eyes right now, but that's okay. I'm going to learn.
Right, this is Monica again, and she's
wearing a dress. Very nice.
Right off the rack. I didn't touch a thing. It fits her perfectly. And we were surprised because we found it at prom time. We felt for sure. We felt lucky that we got this one. This is going to be in the resort section.
Okay.
We're using resort as an excuse to show summer clothing that you wouldn't normally see in a fall winter.
Do you like this, Monica?
Yeah.
Would you wear it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Might be something from Star Trek.
Oh, the one shoulder.
It is like the
original Star Trek.
It's silk chiffon with a silk satin lining. It was probably very expensive.
Wow.
And I think it was priced at like $12. I know.
Wow.
I know.
So all you did was hem it for
her. I didn't even hem it. I told her to put shoes on.
Perfect.
Wow. Turn around.
She would look good in a burlap sack. But
yes, she's young. And absolutely.
Yes, she's a pretty girl. But we have a lot of items like this right off the rack. Probably a third of the items I only had to put together, style a little bit.
Wow. Mm-hmm. Is there like a way to approach it, like when you go into the store, like how's it set up? Like you just go in and you just kind of dig through it, kind of like TJ Maxx?
No,
or
very organized.
Very organized. We actually did a lot of research on how people shop. Mm-hmm. So when you walk in the store, you kind of decompress and you take a look around. Are you looking for children's clothes? Are you looking for mm-hmm. men?
Right.
And so we have those department signs, so you can easily see mm-hmm. if you're looking for something like women's clothes, you know right where to go.
So there's mm-hmm. no biting and
oh, kicking. Oh, no. No, not at all.
If you go with your girlfriend sometimes, you fight over the
that's
one good
right.
thing. Yeah, the good
this
thing.
Jealousy yeah. starts mm-hmm. when you find the mm-hmm. great deal.
Oh, my goodness. Well, let's reiterate again, just so if anybody's tuning in, tell us where you can get tickets again. Tell us the location. Give us that stuff again.
September 10th, mm-hmm. Thursday.
429.
That's right, 429. Mm-hmm. And then we don't forget the exclusive after party at Viva. And it's going to be at VF Outlet, third floor designer's place. Mm-hmm. That's where the runway show is going to be. And tickets, $40. They'll be $45 at the door.
And you still get $40 tickets?
Still, mm-hmm. you can get $48 tickets up to
September 9th or 10th.
September 10th.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
September 10th, you'll need to purchase them at the door.
Okay.
And if you'd like to get them ahead of time, you can go to yourgoodwill.org, buy them right online, or you can stop by the Bell Tower, the store at Bell Tower, Spring Valley Athletic Club. They're also selling tickets. So there's a couple ways right there. Very easy to get tickets.
Cool. Very good.
Mm-hmm.
Very good. I just think that it's a great cause, and we have just about 4 minutes here, and just to reiterate again, the donations go, they stay right here in Berks County.
That's very important.
And they're for people with disabilities. And mm-hmm. is it physical or mental disability? Or
that is correct.
Everything.
Correct.
Okay.
You know, whether they're dealing with mental, physical challenges, mm-hmm. Even people that have a disadvantage, like we were talking about.
Socioeconomic.
That's right. Like, for example, someone's working on their GED and just trying to get some work experience and understanding why or how to dress, you know, proper for work and right. why it's important to show mm-hmm. up for work on time mm-hmm. and social skills at work as well. So we work with a lot of different people who need a little help, and we, again, find what they're good at, what they want to do, and really try to match them up with the right training and job opportunity.
And they just come right to your facilities here in Berks County and Lancaster and all the other
supply.
Right, that's supply. Right. And again, anyone that's interested can go to yourgoodwill.org and find a location that's best for them.
Okay.
Very good.
Very good. All right. Well, I don't know how much time we have left.
BCTV has a let's plug BCTV.
Why don't we plug Oktoberfest? Well, let's say goodbye to our
yeah.
guests.
Okay.
So thank you so very much.
Thank you so much for having us again.
The Goodwill Runway Show. I have
That's
to say
right.
that very that like is a tongue twister. But what a great cause! And
well,
thank you so much. Thank you, Monica.
Thank you.
It was wonderful. So.
You look great.
Good
thank
luck.
You.
Beautiful.
Thank,
good
you.
Luck.
Thank you.
Thank you. This is going to be very exciting.
Oh yes. So. We could plug Oktoberfest.
Yeah, I saw something earlier on Oktoberfest.
Right. Well, it's the week of October 19th, and we have arts, we have restaurants and entertainment, there's sports, but if you're interested, just go to bctv.org. You can see all the different nights and all the different things. It's easy to get a bidder number. Just give a call here to BCTV.
You have to get your bidder number,
and you can either call in. I know they're going to stream it live. I'm hosting the entertainment, the restaurant and entertainment. There's the register to bid information. Thanks, Joe.
You guys are on the ball.
They are on the ball. But the merchandiser is the sponsor this year. It'll be held at the Fairgrounds Square Mall. You can go to the Fairgrounds Square Mall and get kind of caught up in the live bidding, or you can watch it on TV, or they stream it live on the web as
well. We need your support.
Absolutely.
Keep Marcia and me on the air, huh?
So there's the lineup. So you have home and family, recreation and leisure. I'll be hosting Dining Out and Entertainment with George Audi on Wednesday the 21st. We've got crafts featuring the Reading Berks Guilds of Craftsmen, sports, which is always very popular.
That's fun.
And then the BCTV family, celebrities, and Fairgrounds Square Mall merchants and
We certainly want to thank the merchandiser and the Fairground Square Mall for their generous their sponsors. So please tune in and watch it. But anyway, we'll see you next
month. Good night. Thank you.
Thank you.
Berks Vibe is underwritten by Kopicki Photography, 300 Cherry Street, Reading, PA, 19602.